Hey, beautiful people, how are you all doing today? Hope you all are fantastic. So I know the topic of my video, the title of my video is a little controversial, but it is something if you are maybe in your late 20s, your mid 30s, or approaching your 40s and you're not married yet, it's probably something that somebody has said to you. I know for me personally, it's something that was said to me a long time ago, before I was even married, before I even had a child. Somebody, one of my workmates, were sitting down talking to me. She's like, so Sheila, you're this age. That's me, Sheila. You're this age and you are not married and you don't have kids. What's wrong with you? Yep, that was the question that she casually asked me, what's wrong with me? And I'm sometimes a smart ass, so I'm sarcastic and I'm like, well, I decided to get an education. Okay. But I didn't really get into it, so I kind of changed the subject. And another time, it's in town. I should mention that I moved from a big city, Toronto, to this little small town in northern Alberta. So how my old workmate would describe it is like the 1950s came in here and got stuck. Basically, it's not unusual to find somebody who's been married since she was 18 and started having children, you know? And it's not unusual to find stay-at-home moms in this town. It's just common and nobody bats an eyelash. However, coming from a big city, that's very different. At my age, a lot of my friends either had just been finishing school, getting into their careers, or just, you know, living their best single life. And of course, I moved away from that environment to a small town, and I became somehow like my lack of marriage and children became an elephant in the room. But I'm not here to talk about that, and I'm not here to give you pointers on how to get a man, because that's not what I do. I can give you some suggestions and some things that I paid attention to in order to kind of orient my life towards like what I wanted eventually. And this is not due to any pressure from people around me, not even my parents. I'll get on that later about my parents, specifically my mother. But no one was really in my family pressuring me to get married. But I made the decision eventually. I was like, you know what? I'm tired of just kind of like dating, and a lot of the times I just really get bored of people and just kind of like ghost. I was notorious for ghosting. It's just, I'm grateful for the fact that I always ghosted, and I have no regrets. I'll get back to that later. But I just want to say to you 20-somethings, 30-somethings, or even 40-somethings who are not yet married, marriage is not an accessory you just pick up and use, something that you decide you want to do. It's a lifetime commitment, and so is parenting. So when you decide, if you decide that that's what you want for yourself, it's going to be obviously with somebody you're compatible with somebody you don't mind spending the rest of your life with. And the thing about the way we talk about marriage, you put so much pressure on young women to get married. Well, you should be married at this age. However, we don't discuss the tools and the mindset necessary in order to prepare us for marriage. For example, my own mother never talked to me about marriage. I do recall she'd be really irritable and really irritated when I'd be, you know, talking to somebody. She'd be very cold, some of them were jerks, but that's just not the kind of mom that she was. She wouldn't sit you down and say, honey, you know what, when I was this age, like, these are the kind of, you know, these are the kind of guys that I dated. Like, there was none of that discussion. There was nothing. We didn't talk about sex. We didn't talk about my period. My mom did not talk to me about anything of the sort. And so when I was thrown into relationships, it was just like a clusterfuck of so many different things. Oh, excuse me, I just swore, but maybe I can beep it out. Anyway, I'm not gonna edit this video. It's just gonna be raw as is. So anyway, back to my original point. Society always puts pressure on women to get married, to be a mother, to be a wife, but they don't really prepare them mentally and emotionally for the things that entails to be a mother and a wife, because these are lifetime commitments, as I mentioned. And nobody says, you know what, nobody talks about compatibility, nobody talks about, you know, you're dating, what are their life goals, what's their five-year plan, what are their temperaments, how do they behave in public, how do they treat service workers. And those things are very important. I'll make a video about certain traits to look out for in a partner that's kind of like red flags and you should just like run for the hills. I know this from personal experience, and I just want to save a lot of people heartache and disappointment and just potentially not making the wrong decision. Anyway, so if you're thinking about getting married, there's one person in particular. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with Chanel Cooper Sykes. There's something that she said, one thing that she said that I did, and I'm not saying that this is the direct reason I got married. I'm just saying it kind of like set the tone for me going towards that direction. So when I was first started dating my now husband, I remember watching a video from Chanel Cooper Sykes, and she mentioned that when you're dating, you should, like, you're obviously not gonna go to the person you're newly dating and say, I wanna get married and let's get married, or ask them how many kids they want. Obviously not. You're gonna be like, that's nutty. So what you're basically gonna say is, at the beginning, the very, very, very beginning, be like, my intention is to get married. I'm not saying that you and I are gonna get married. However, I'm this age, you know, and I don't see myself just frivolously dating people for the sake of dating. I would like to eventually end up in a situation where I'm somebody's wife and somebody's my husband and I'm somebody's mother. And that's all you have to say. And reiterate that I'm not saying that you and I are gonna get married. However, that is my intention. And if that's not your intention, that's cool. If you still wanna like date, and from there on, you kind of sort of decide like how, like, intimate you're going to be with this partner, what kind of activities you're going to involve in, and if you're going to go on vacation together eventually, if you're going to move in together, and like having that conversation is basically going to set the tone. And if they are of the same mind, obviously things are going to go, you know, the way you want to go, and if they're not, they're going to find a way to kind of like go. But anyway, if you're not married right now and you don't have kids and you're late 20s, in your 30s, in your 40s, don't put that pressure on yourself, because getting married is not a thing to do. There's life-changing decisions. I mean, your entire name has to be changed. There's so many documents you have to change for that. That's like administrative stuff. But in terms of lifestyle and what you're gonna do and the kind of activities you're gonna do, that's gonna change as well. And then once you become a mother, that's a whole nother ball game of life change, not just physical life change, emotional life changes, some for the good and some for the better. I mean, you will learn boundaries like nobody's business, which is a good thing. I'll get into like other videos later. I don't want to make this video too long. But anyway, don't feel society's pressure to make you feel inadequate because you're not married yet or you don't have kids yet. It's a life, both are a lifetime commitment if that's your intention. So don't be frivolous with those decisions as well. There are a lot of videos out here of a lot of angry, bitter, they call themselves MGTO or red pill guys. It sounds like they've had like really horrible relationships and they've made like really bad decisions. Everybody's made bad decisions. I've dated some horrible men, but my mindset was completely different when I met my husband. I had no intention of even like dating him whatsoever, but that's a whole nother story. I'm not gonna get into that right now. But like I made the decision to say, okay, this experience that I had was horrible. I've learned from it. It was terrible. I never want to repeat it again. But I didn't have the mindset that all men were pigs and awful human beings. So basically, a lot of the things that kind of like, I guess, ushered me into this lifestyle, I guess if you want to call being married a lifestyle, but it's just my life right now, that ushered me into this lifestyle being a wife and a mother, was basically the mindset that I had and a few things that I was consciously looking out for in a partner versus just like kind of dating somebody and then finding out they're like a bit of a psycho and having to like literally run for my life. I'll get into those stories later, but anyway, I hope you all are having a fantastic week, and I will see you guys in my next video. So if there is something that you want me to talk about, just mention in the comments below. I know you guys are really quiet and some of you are really shy. Don't be shy, talk to me, because this is basically why I'm here. Anyway, stay blessed, beautiful people.